I wasn't really going to do a Drone My Life video, but since Dr. Tigreed insisted, first play my intro. Hi, my name is ecoli0157h7. I come from a very large and well-known family, Escutia. Maybe you've heard of us? Despite how big my family is, I'm actually quite special. Compared to my cousin, I'm a very good swimmer and I'm also quite hairy. But we are all about the same height and size, around 2 micrometers in height and 0.5 micrometers circumference. My lineage apparently originated when my great-great-grandpa was transduced by a Shigella toxin gene. A few years later, he tied the plastic with my great-great-great-grandma, a non-pathogenic E. coli. And so, this is where my story begins. I was born and raised inside my best friend's intestinal reservoir, Bella the cow. Unfortunately, in 1993, Bella died. But I'm still with her! Bella was minced and moved to this place called Burger Paradise. But for me, it was hell! It was hot, over 40 degrees Celsius hot. I was surrounded by bun, lettuce, cheese, and sauce. I thought I was going to die, but I survived! And then, I saw my one true love. A pretty E. coli was sitting on a lettuce, but our romance was ended before it could even begin. Because I was ingested by a human! For my one true love, I had to fight back. First, I attached myself to the human's intestinal epithelial cell and injected PIR receptors so that I could firmly bind with my intimate outer membrane protein. After attaching myself firmly, I formed long strands of actin, then released my hidden power. Sugar toxin!
3 days later.
My human sure didn't like my vengeful tactics as I started feeling abdominal pain and her bloody diarrhea. I was having too much fun, and I didn't realize that I caused so much trouble that my name made it onto the news. Humans wanted to find me. No one understood me. I found myself in a sorbitol McConkieager. Humans starved me, because there was no lactose, only B-sorbitol, which I could not ferment. In order to survive, I need to be colorless and boring. I need to hide myself and stay safe with other E. coli, hoping that no one could find me. My extended E. coli family would laugh at my helplessness. I kept their vanity of fermenting sorbitol to produce bright pink pigmentation wasn't enough salt to my injury. I thought I was safe, but I was wrong. I was so, so wrong. The human so-called scientist sent latex reagents from the 0157 antibody, H7 flagella antibody, and control headquarters to hunt me down. Surrounded by the 0157 and H7 reagents, I agglutinated. The other E. coli strains were spared by agglutinating with the control latex reagent. The scientists have found me. They found me. They began asking questions like,
I am the demonstrator. You will now undergo the mug trial in question of your potential to cleave mug substrate. This will ultraviolently shine light on the truth of your deeds. Do you possess a beta-glucuronidase enzyme?
No.
Then I plead you guilty of committing pathogenic activity, sentencing you to negative gram staining.
Well, after all of that, I was able to escape and went far deep to Bikini Bottom. My life isn't so bad now that I've reunited with my one true love. And so, here it is, Dr. Tigreed. The story of E. coli 0157H7.
Mm-hmm.